Hey, what's up, everybody? Mark in Japan, back at it again here. And today, I came across some crazy stuff. I'm going to share with you, like, the most outrageous laws I could find in Japan. So, let's start. Okay, number one, 45 categories for waste separation. Crazy. A small town of Kamikatsujo, Tokushima Prefecture, has a goal of reaching zero waste. It's only 1,600 people, and they have set up a policy where you have to separate your garbage into 45 different categories of separation. Ridiculous. But they started this back in 2003, and as of 2016, they reached their goal of 81%.
Pause.
As of 2016, they reached 81% recycle rate. The name of their policy is Zero Waste Policy, and they have up until 2020 to hit it. I'm really hoping that they'll make it there. That'll really show the rest of the world that we can get zero waste, you know, and recycle everything. Crazy law, though. 45 categories. All right, number two. For 6 million yen, if you have 7 children. Wow. Fukaura Machi in Aomori Prefecture is wanting to pay for children. Now, they're known for their tuna and their world natural heritage of a place I can't pronounce because it's crazy, but it'll be here below. So their population has decreased immensely because of the lack of people just having kids, getting in relationships. Because of this, they're willing to pay for you to have kids and live in their little slice of heaven, their little agricultural paradise town. So they're wanting people so badly, according to the town website, that they're willing to pay $5,000 after the third child. At one point, it used to be 1 million yen, so $10,000 after the third child, and then it got gradually all the way up to 6 million yen, so $60,000 for 7 children. This is crazy, but as of now, there's been no new updates to the website in the past couple years, so I don't know how accurate this policy still is. Number three. Death notifications for dogs? Yes. Japan, you don't only just have to register man's best friend, but you also have to notify the nearest city hall whenever your dog passes away. Crazy enough, the reason for this law is because of Japan's Rabies Prevention Act. You have to register your dog within 30 days of the death, is to cut down on, obviously, rabies. And this law has been so effective that Japan hasn't had an outbreak of rabies in any dogs since 1957. Crazy. But even crazier thing, even though cats can also get rabies, cat owners don't have to register their fur babies and don't have to notify anybody whenever they die either, even though they can get rabies just as easy. Number four, Booby City. Crazy enough, Hikari City in Yamaguchi Prefecture declared themselves back in 2005 Booby City. Despite the interesting word choice for the town's slogan, Booby City. Say it one more time with me, Booby City. Is an actual ordinance by the town to help promote breastfeeding in Japan and in their city. According to recent papers, Japan, breastfeeding was the norm in Japan for a very, very, very long time, like it was in every other part of the world. But with modern advances and with women just not being able to breastfeed as much, the percentage of breastfeeding has went down to 30% in Japan. And the town wants to help destigmatize breastfeeding, wants to help bring it back, wants a more natural remedy for feeding your children, wants everything to be okay for women just to feel comfortable with breastfeeding again. So they have went up and beyond and out of their way, declaring their city Booby City. Say it with me once again. Booby City holds their annual Booby Fest every summer. Number 5. No human cloning. Japan has went and declared a law against human cloning. Didn't even know it needed to be done. But apparently, 4 years after Dolly the sheep was successfully cloned, Japan went and declared a law saying there will not be any human cloning. Any person found in violation of human cloning, yes, any person found human cloning or attempting to clone humans can get 10 years imprisonment. Hard labor. Because of these restrictions in Japan, science, a lot of Japanese sciences have moved to parts of the world where they do not care. Maybe we got a couple people walking around right now, they're just Japanese clones and we just don't know it. Number 6. No condoms for underage children shall be sold in Nagasaki. Back in 1978, Nagasaki Prefecture made a law that said nobody under the age of 18 shall be sold condoms. They started this so that nobody under the age of 18 would be having sex. However, this massively failed because Nagasaki has a above average abortion rate compared to the rest of Japan. Obviously, this law has failed immensely. It makes no sense. It would probably be way better if they just sold condoms to kids. Which sounds terrible, saying it out loud. But at least they'd be safe and protected. The Nagasaki branch of the Japan Society of OBGYN has fought and pushed back at this law so much, but it still exists. Number 7, wear pants, people! According to Article 1, Paragraph 20 of Minor Offenses in Japan, it is illegal to show your buttocks or thighs without any good reason. This law was established back in 1948. And it carries a maximum penalty of 28 days in prison. But the law relies heavily on other people. So it relies on how much of, or showing the entirety of one's posterior and thighs to another party, and then how offended or offended at all the other party is, will determine if you even get charged. Number 8. Act relating to duel. This 131-year-old law prohibits anybody in Japan from participating in a duel. It also states that any person mediating, witnessing, assisting, accomplishing, accompanying, running around, in the background, of said duel, anybody in facility of duel, etc. and etc. may be subject to prosecution. Challenging somebody to a duel or accepting a duel can get you a 6-month minimum prison sentence to a maximum of 2 years prison sentence. Participating in a duel can get you 2 years to 5 years prison sentence. It has been a dead law for more than 100 years, but it has recently been applied to one-on-one fights amongst Japanese men and women. Bonus, your husband's member doesn't work. Divorce. When finalizing a divorce in Japan, usually you have to have grounds for divorce. So this means that a woman can divorce her husband for impotence. This also covers a wide variety of other things, such as maybe your partner is becoming transgender, has a weird fetish, has sexual desires that are way beyond what you want to do. All right, I hope you guys found this really interesting. I know I did. Hope to see you guys in the next video. Go ahead and subscribe. Hit that notification bell. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.